First, I want to congratulate all the survivors in here. Woo-hoo! I give myself a round of applause. I'm a survivor.
Amen.
My wife is a survivor. Woo-hoo! And I know what it takes to be a survivor. Nice. When I think of survivor, I think of fighter. I am John Obafemi Jones. I am an artist. I live on the U.S. Virgin Islands. I also am a prostate cancer survivor. I conducted a pastel workshop for breast cancer survivors. The goal of the workshop was to provide an opportunity for breast cancer survivors to navigate this catastrophic disease. Hopefully after the workshop, they will continue to use some of the things they learned.
As a participant in the art therapy class, it was wonderful because I sat next to some women who had similar experiences. We talked about our treatment, we talked about our children, you know, we talked about the future.
I find myself being able to relax, and it's very soothing, and it's broadening my horizons on how to do different art projects. I never tried pastels before, and I find it fascinating.
It was warm when the instructor came by and just looked us in the eye. You know, Mr. Jones looked us in the eye, and the tears welled up because it felt like I was home.
It was nice being with them to see I'm not alone as a breast cancer survivor.
Art basically is a discipline, which means it requires focus. And when you're in the throes of cancer, so many things are on your mind that it could make you depressed, make you full of anxiety. So you must find ways to cope with that.
I came down to visit a friend of mine on vacation. And she told me about this event where we would be working with other breast cancer survivors on a pastel art project. And I was really excited about doing that, something a little different. And I really enjoyed it, working with other survivors and someone who took the time to work with survivors.
I was very intimidated by going to pastels because I'm not a painter, all right? I do other forms of art, if you can call it that. But this was going to be a challenge. And I must say, I'm very pleased with what I did. The teacher was fabulous. John Jones was fabulous. He explained what it was going to be about and how to do it and how to blend it and all that kind of thing, and gave us suggestions, and then didn't give us suggestions because he wanted it to be our work of art. And I enjoyed that. I enjoyed that.
At first, I was so intimidated. But John, the instructor, John Jones, He just nailed it on the head. He told us exactly what to start with, circles, using your shoulders instead of your wrists. And I did that. He was a great instructor. And my masterpiece came out like a masterpiece. I love it. I love it. It's going to be framed and everything.
While I was painting, the only thing I could think of, I wanted it to kind of look like, you know, the still life. But for me, it was more being able to experiment, because I don't feel like an artist at all. And now I'm very proud of my production.
If there's one thing cancer does, it brings people together. Because you could be the richest person, which I've met people that were wealthy, actually. And we always have that one common ground, talking about cancer and how we're going to beat it. Just to be able to have a little commonality with the women that were in the workshop was great for me. And it also helped us develop support, because you really need support when you're battling cancer.
The benefits for events like this are encouragement, Also, just feeling good that we are survivors and that we can continue to live our best life and we can still have fun and be happy, and that this was just a pothole in our journey of life.
I think events like this are lifesavers, because you never know when you're isolated. Sometimes depression can set in, right? You think you're the only person on the planet. It's super fun, and you know, you get to build community, right? You get to see people that look like you and have the same experience.
It keeps people encouraged. It makes people get their mind off of whatever pains that they're going through or will go through. It gives us somebody to talk to and, well, what happened to you and what happened to me? And sometimes it helps just to talk about what your experience with cancer was.